You shouldn't drink right now.
I can't hear you when you mumble.
Have you seen Lily's things? What wasn't burned at the funeral?
Is that stuff supposed to be here, or...?
Nope, haven't seen it.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really? The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
And he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
I'm after Crane, all right? The guy we all hate? And there's a time limit here, so try and focus for a minute.
Crane?
We'll get to whatever you're here for in a sec. That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay? Can't say you being there helped things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away though, didn't they? Whatever. It's alright. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here.
Now, yeah, right? Yeah, I know, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Gren, Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
To the dead.
All right, now help me.
Gren, the doc said you needed a rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it, it's done! What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
I don't want anything from you, Woody.
I absolutely cannot babysit you dumbasses right now. So end whatever this is, so we can just move past it.
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks. He thinks you have to pay chicks to touch your fat, hairy ass. That's what he thinks.
I think whatever happened was between them, and Lily is dead. So let's put this whole thing to rest, Gren.
Gren. I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule.
I thought you said you would help me look.
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Closed, and Lily ain't around anyway, so you can run off back to the woods, I guess. Did you care about her at all? She was a nice girl. Ran around too much.
Of course I cared. I still care.
I hope so. I hope you do. I don't know why you fucking came here. There's nothing left for you to ruin. And I'm not in an entertaining mood.
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry for what happened. I'll make it up to you.
Yeah, sure you will, kid. When the rivers turn coarse and the sky bleeds fucking gypsies. Lily's funeral. It was just so fucked tonight. But I still wish you could have been there. I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit. I don't know. I don't know why he showed up. I just wish he'd get out of my fucking life.
He's trying to do what's right.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, you know him better than anybody, so... I guess I'll take your word for it.
If you were getting your glamour on this day... One of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf. Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Oh, thank God. Tell me you found something.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on, White Plains Avenue, 1284. It's an apartment complex.
Great. Let's get going. Crane's meeting her in a few minutes.
All right, let's go. I don't want to miss him.
I'll meet you there.
All right, I'll see you there.
Bigby!
I just got here.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know. This is it.
All right. How do you want to do this? Hear anything?
If anyone's in there, they're being awfully quiet.
Sorry about that.
Is something wrong?
Where's Crane? Is he still here?
Huh? I don't know who that is. I'm sorry, I don't really...
Are you the missus of the house? Or is your mother at home?
My mommy's not here. She's probably working.
Do you have a name?
Rachel, who are you? Just so... we're not strangers.
Well, I'm the sheriff, and this is my partner.
Boss.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Is there anything you need? I'm not allowed to let people in.
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, you know, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right. Is there... something you want?
Snow, can you just do something here? I never have any idea what to say to these people.
You mean children? Do you mind if my friend here takes a look around? I promise we'll be quick so you can hurry back to bed.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here. Okay, boss. I'm gonna trust your friend not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
Look for anything unusual.
Yeah, like Crane. He could still be here.
No one's been over all night, so... how much longer do you think it'll be?
Let me guess. Big band or classical?
Honky-tonk.
No accounting for taste. It's pretty rare to see a burner like this.
Dowdy. That's how we like it.
Your mom a hunter?
Oh no, she never... that was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain, I think.
That your mom?
Uh-huh.
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
Not here.
There's no one here but me. Where do you buy your clothes?
At a store.
Oh. My mommy makes all...
Butcher.
What's that?
A package. Having to do with someone called the Butcher. I saw one just like it at the Tweedle's office. There's nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See? I saw a spider over there yesterday.
Oh?
It was a pretty one.
God damn it.
I shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
I keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break it.
You don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move. I don't want to get in trouble.
I'm not gonna break it. I just want to open it.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me. The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Anti-crate leaf.
It hurts when you do it that way. First. What?
You picked the wrong night to lie to me. No more lying, no more ring around the rosy, no more bullshit non sequiturs. You're done. It's over. You're gonna tell me what I want to know right now.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
Where's Crane? Speak quickly.
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
Just why in the name of everything holy are you protecting this weaselly scumbag? I mean, what on earth could he have done to deserve this kind of loyalty?
Crane could be hollow bones tomorrow, and you wouldn't see me cry a drop. But that doesn't mean I can tell you anything. You have friends. Don't you? Well, I don't want Crane's friends for enemies.
If you're not protecting Crane, who are you protecting?
Get this through both of your skulls. I can't tell you. Just you being here is bad enough. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something, you have to forget it.
We can protect you, okay? Whatever it is you're afraid of, we can make sure that it won't come to pass.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap if she's afraid for her life. We can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
Isn't there another way? She's a witch. Can't she just work for us? That way she'd be official.
You want to reward her for criminal behavior? We can't trust this woman on the 13th floor.
It doesn't matter, because I'd never do it. I'm not a house cat, and I don't play well with others.
Oh, trust me, no one would confuse you for a cuddly animal. Bigby, this is an order. Burn the tree.
No! Look, look, I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of dispel. You know, that it will pierce the protection around the girls' speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago.
I'm sorry, but we still can't let you keep the tree. It wouldn't be right after what's happened. Bigby.
Please, Sheriff. Don't.
Today's your lucky day, Greenleaf. I'm hiring you as the business office's newest witch in residence.
But Bigby!
The witches over there will keep her out of trouble, and we have a glamour shortage as it is. It makes the most sense now. And you get to keep your fucking tree.
Just don't expect me to bow down to your little woman here.
Don't think for a second that this is over.
So what? Are moving trucks gonna show up here or something?
Something like that.
We'll call you.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss a spot? Mr. Clean come to smash up the rest of my place. Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
Where's Crane?
Ichabod Crane? What would that nerd have with a place like this? Hey, you can't just go in there. We have a problem.
Tell me who did it. Just tell me who did it. I know you know.
Mr. Crane, please. She can't help.
I know you know what the plan is. I won't be held accountable for this.
I can't. I can't. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God. Bigby.
Wait, don't.
I didn't do anything. I promise you, I didn't do anything. These girls. The girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get this stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell. But once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over. That's all. Please. I'm innocent. Completely, completely innocent. It's just let me show you.
The ring won't work. Greenleaf sold you out.
What? No. This will work. I assure you, it must. I went to you. Damn you, come on. Please. Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many. But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. I just... Oh, God.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know. That was... I just
love you, Snow. I love you, and I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love. Bigby? I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women? He's not... He wouldn't be brave enough not to put his stamp on the world like that. He's a disgusting coward, not a murderer.
Thank you, my dear. It means so much.
We've been chasing this guy. Just... why now?
Because... look at him. You've said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown, of using our money for his own... ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
Yes, I know how this...
this fuck-up knows more than he's saying.
I don't!
Yes, okay, he probably does. But there's a difference between being involved and being the guy who did it.
Okay, but if Crane didn't kill Faith and Lily, I'm sorry, but who the hell did? You know, when I saw you come back here, I thought this was over.
Now, I know, and I'm sorry, but...
this whole thing is bigger than Crane. He wouldn't have the stones to send the Tweedles after me. Somebody else is involved.
Well, shit.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
you've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you? Yeah. We're not gonna kill you, so quit your shivering. Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses, but as of right now, you're coming with us.
You are extraordinarily lucky Miss White was here to save your ass. Because if it was up to me, you'd have your head swinging from the Washington Bridge.
Okay, Sheriff, that's enough. This can't be Greenleaf again and again, behaving however you like, acting without constraint. You have to respect this office, Bigby. And you have to respect me as its leader. Starting now.
You think you have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon. I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me. Oh, God.
If I were you, I'd keep that trap of yours shut.
What are you saying?
What you got there? Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now. The grown-ups are talking.
Who are you?
No. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee. What's the, you know, that thing the Mundus call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax. This is my job. I like my job.
He's in custody, so move your car.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Fuck it.
Bigby? Just didn't know when to end. You know, you wouldn't think silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But as it turns out, it's just a big use. Right, Wolfie? Hey, look, I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys, can you argue with these results? Because I know I can't. Wait! Stop! Just take them, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Snow, don't do this.
It's your lucky day, kid. The Crooked Man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomachache? Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended. Nope, not like your boyfriend here. Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen. I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
He's lucky to be alive, and he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
This is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What do you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
When people hear what you did to Dom, they're going to think you've gone back to your old ways.
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point, do you?
Thank you.